Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can quickly remove blanks or duplicates, whether it be in rows or cells in Microsoft Excel. So the first thing I want to show you is how to delete empty or blank rows in Microsoft Excel. And you can see in this data set here, I have some blank rows. Now you could go through and select each row here, hold down control, go to the next one, go to the next one if you keep holding down control, and then you could right click and delete them all. And that way it would work. But if you had a long data set that you're going through, it's a very inefficient use of time. So a better way to do is go up to your home tab, and if you go all the way to the very end, you'll see find and select in the ribbon. So just select that and then go to special, just like that. Now I want to point out a shortcut that you can do at the same time. I'm just going to close this. If I use Control G, this opens up, and then you can just click on special and you get the same spot. So if you like using shortcuts, try the Control G. Now, once you're into this go to special, you can see that we have blanks right here. So I'm going to click on blanks and I'm just going to hit OK. So what it's going to do is it goes through and selects all the blanks in this spreadsheet here. Now, all I have to do is go up to my ribbon under the Home tab and go to Delete. So once you find Delete, you can drop down. And it will work in a couple different ways. Usually if I'm just trying to delete rows, I'll go to delete rows, but you can also delete cells and shift everything up. But in this case, I'm just going to hit delete sheet rows, just like that. And you can see now all my empty or blank rows in this spreadsheet in Excel are gone. So that's a much quicker way to delete these blanks. So for this next tip, I want to show you how you can replace blanks with a different numerical value. So what I mean by this is I'm going to go ahead and just delete around five of these to give some data to change here. So that should be about five through here. Now, what we're going to do is be able to select all the blanks in this column and then quickly change them to zero. I could change it to any number, but in this case, we don't want, if they are supposed to be blank being zero, we just want zero in each of all of these. So what I'm going to do first, though, is to find the blanks in this column. I need to select the column first, use my Control G, like I did before, or you can go to the Find and Select, hit Special, and go to Blanks again. So I'm going to hit OK. And now you can see that all the blanks are selected there, the five of them. If I just type zero, just like that, and then hit Control plus Enter, look how that fills all the empties in with zero. So I could have done this with a different number if you know it's the same number that you're putting in. So now I remove those blanks and put a different numerical value on it. So give that a try. You don't have to use numbers either. If you wanted to write something in, you can do the same idea and just use the Control Enter, and it fills in also with the letters. So the last thing what I want to show you is how to remove duplicates inside Microsoft Excel. So in this data here, I did put a few duplicates. So you can see if I look at 25, I have Baker Mayfield here, and I actually copied the whole row over and I got it again. And there's two others that I did that too. So there should be three in total. So let's say you want to make sure you don't have any duplicates in your data. What you need to do is go up to the data tab right here. And if you're looking through the ribbon, move over until you find remove duplicates right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and select this. Now, what you need to do is, in this case, so I want to make a match on every column. So it's going to go through here and then it's going to make sure that's that duplicate. But if you knew it was only a certain one column, you would uncheck these. My data has headers up there too. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit OK. And it said three duplicate values found and remove 50 unique values remain. So if I hit OK, and then if I start to go through it, if I look at 25, and then I move down to 40, you can see that other Baker Mayfield isn't there, and the two others were deleted as well. So I hope you like these quick tips about cleaning up your empty rows or cells, or replacing numbers into different cells, or finding those duplicates. It can save you a lot of time if you use these techniques when going through. Let me know what you think with this and down in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.